Operational report. Submarines have been detected. Crash. Repairs complete. Detection. 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 Sighting report. Kill credit. Kill credit. Supplies moved. Repairs complete. Yes. Oh, here's some very interesting points. We have some of the upgrades. Some devices are upgraded on the artillery and the engineers. Okay, we'll check those off later. But here's something that is significant, and I should have been more careful, but we got away with it. We have 43rd Division. A, B, and C elements have updated. What can happen, and often does happen, if you're not careful, is whenever these units are dispersed, I always turn off the upgrade. Why? Because sometimes A and B will upgrade, or A will upgrade, and B and C will not. If that happens, you can't recombine the damn unit. And it fights like hell, and it's just a pain in the bloody butt. So I got lucky on these two. They upgraded all three of them at the same time, but I can't be trusting luck all the time. I need to be more diligent or else I'm going to get burned. In one campaign game, it took me, I think, 3-4 weeks to upgrade the rest of it so that they could recombine. It's just a nightmare, a freaking nightmare. Submarine back, Baker, two of them, Edward Baker? Yes, at Pagan. More upgrades on the artillery. I'll show what's happening at the artillery. I-Core, lots of core artillery upgrades. And a sinking. Okay, let's deal with that first. Artillery. Where are the upgrades? Okay, I think this was another one of the upgrades. Yeah, we upgraded. The problem with artillery, well, not problem, was I allowed the artillery to upgrade because we had 36 howitzers already, and they were just adding some more motorized support and other additional howitzers. Now we don't have them; they don't have them in stock. But all we did was upgrade the organization, and they are adding to it. They weren't taking anything away, so I didn't have a problem. I just let them upgrade. Now I'll turn it off. But we're still trying to recover additional anti-aircraft artillery and motorized support. So that takes a while. That takes a while. So I'll leave it in rest mode because it's easier to receive replacements in rest mode than it is in combat mode. So here, same thing. We had 36 already and we're just adding more. That's okay. If we're just adding more, that's not a problem. Let's take a look at the engineers. The engineers, the first Australian engineers, these guys upgraded. And I turned it off already. They upgraded and they had a full complement because there were enough devices in here just to do a full upgrade and not wait and not need any more. Good. Good. The last one that we saw was the cavalry. The cavalry, which is the cavalry regiment. Yeah, here. This one, see, this is what happens when you don't have enough stock in the rear, I believe. You should be getting 18, and because there wasn't enough to immediately upgrade everybody, well, they did it. Now we have to be chasing after replacements, and this can take a while. I think that's what happened. Anyway, we're going to put this in rest, hopefully, so we can recover these in time for the invasion. Because you don't want to be up here in the armor. I'm going to turn off. I turned off my upgrades because let's take a look at the Aussie one. For example, this one here. Nope. There's an Aussie regiment here. Oh, where are you, man? Here's the regiment. See, we've upgraded some of these to Churchill's, and they upgraded successfully because there was a stock. But now we're short three Churchill tanks, so we're chasing after it, trying to fill it up before the invasion. And I want the armor along. But the Matildas, there's 18 of them, so we got a mixed group here. If I leave the upgrade on, they will upgrade, but I might only get one or two Matildas, or two Churchills. Is it worth two Churchills or 18 Matildas? I'd rather have 18 Matilda, functional Matilda tanks than one or two Churchill. So that's all these stupid little things you got to keep track of. Like this here, Shermans. Would I rather have, I don't know what's better, but would I rather have a full complement of Churchills? Sure, I'd rather have it nice and uniform, but we just don't have enough. We can check on here and see is it the New Zealand or the Australian? It's the Australians, I think. Right, the Churchills. Or is it British? No, it's the Australians. As the Churchills come, they come once per day. So it's going to take a whole month to gather 48, or a month and a half to gather 48. We don't have a month and a half to gather 48. And there are all the other units. Plus, if we're in combat, we're going to be taking losses, so we can't just upgrade here. So do we throw out 18 tanks to get two, or one or two per day? That's just nuts. And we do have a supply of Shermans, and Stuart light tanks. So they may be obsolete or less capable, but they're here. At least we have some. So I've got to be really, I've got to take more care watching my upgrades before I turn on the upgrade. I got to make sure that there are enough. Again, here's another example. These are the A1s. We have about 54 A1s right now. Is 54 better than 72? Oh, sorry, 54 A4s. Is it better than 72? I don't think so. I think I'd rather have the 72, even if they're weaker tanks. Infantry-wise, it was the 98th Division that upgraded. Where are you? Upgrade. So we're lucky. We're lucky they upgraded, because they could have done something half-baked. I'm keeping it. Turn off the upgrade. And we'll keep it dispersed because we have a lot of disabled units that we need to recover. The other one was the 43rd Infantry, and they upgraded as well. So we got lucky, but I can't keep relying on luck. Let's see, any others that are set for upgrade? Okay, we turned them all off. Now the airborne. There's only one airborne, so hopefully we'll upgrade with one shot. So I'm okay with that. We'll upgrade to 45s. The infantry division. Okay, these are 1944s. No, this one's okay. Let's check the first. Oh, there's a couple of these that are. Yeah, you can't sort along here either. The 33rd Division. Now this division is supposed to upgrade to squad 44s. Do I have enough? I don't know. But I do want the squad. The 1941 squads are very, very weak. So I'm going to risk this. But I've got it nice and combined. I'm going to risk this for an upgrade, because we've got about 600 rifle squads ready to go. So I'm hoping for a complete upgrade. The cavalry division upgraded to 44s. Okay, 1944 squads. These, anyone else? Here's another one that needs to upgrade to 1944 squads. So I've got two divisions with enough squads. I don't have enough combat. I don't think I have enough combat engineers. And these are being the combat engineer regiments are vying for these as well. So there's in competition. I'd rather have some combat engineer squad than no combat engineer squad, or half of them. Half, even if the 1944 ones are much better. At least I have some of these, but I can't turn these other ones off, unfortunately. I can't say only do the rifle squads or only do certain things here. I have to, you turn it on, you turn it on. Now I could go into industry here. Oh, for Christ's sakes. And we'll click it again and filter it again and again and again and again every single time we come in here. So we have 680. So theoretically, we could just upgrade all of them, which would be great. Unfortunately, where are the engineers? We don't have so many. Well, we have enough. We have a number of them. So we might be able to. We should be able to do. I think we should be able to do it right across. But you have to keep track of this, and you have to keep coming back to this miserable screen, checking one or two things at a time, or writing it down, or take the stupidity behind it. It just makes it. I am the great supply clerk in the sky. I'm not the great commander. I'm the great. I'm not Chester Nimitz. I'm the lousy supply sergeant. For God's sakes. Checking for crashed ships. We are okay. We might as well take care of Pagan first. This was the no collisions. I don't think there are any additional damaged ships here. But we're at Pagan. So I'm going to form up. This is the damaged transport. Of course, you don't want to show me that. You want to show me all the other garbage. We don't really, really need it here, but there's no point in taking it back. We'll repair, unload, and then head for Pearl Harbor. No more ship collisions. Now we'll check on submarines. Lots to go through. Okay, here's another example of AI stupidity. I'm trying to get this one boat. It's 7 speed, right? So I'm trying to get it into Okinawa, which is only 1, 2, 3, 4 days away. Maybe even less, 3 days. And I keep trying to, and the damn thing just keeps, Sea Fox just keeps switching back to Manila every freaking time. And it won't let me switch around, even though I want to override it and set it over here. Okay, I'm going to try it again. And I'm going to say, go here. And I want you to ignore everything. Direct, absolute, get in here. We want to pump it up, maybe get it up a couple of knots, and then send it back out. Another thing to worry about is every time it drops in here, every time it switches back to this, it goes into, it forms its own, and it drops into full refuel. So got to be careful every time some one of the submarines here, let's see, heading in. I always make sure that they don't suck fuel from here because they got plenty. We're going to repair them and then send them down to Manila where there's plentiful fuel. Naha, everything we have to hump up here. So I try to keep the submarines from grabbing all the fuel. Let's see, are there any others? Well, not right now. At Nago. We have a submarine. This is what I consider ready to sail. 15 knots, okay. Get out of here. Make sure we don't. If I leave it on full refuel, it sometimes sucks fuel before it goes. Yeah, sucks. That's just silly. Speed 12. Let's see. Do we want to repair these? Yeah, I think I'm going to repair it here. We'll put it on critical. Let's see what we can. We'll repair what we can. And then once these guys are ready to go, see Pompon, Jack, and Pargo. Pompon, Jack, and Pargo, they're all 11 knots. That's too slow to get out of here. So I want to get them up to 12, 13 or 14 knots, and then I'll take them out of the shipyard and send them for further repairs in Manila. Here, we have another one. Ship's under repair. Jalau, it's 14 speed, but he's still 55 damage. So I'll leave him there. We've got the Queenfish just came in. I'll put him into pier side while we wait for some room to appear. Hold on. Queenfish at 15 knots. You know, I think we're allowed to get take it back out again. Queenfish, I think we can get out of here without a penalty. Yeah, because we just did it the first day. Okay, so I'm gonna go. Oh, no, I guess not. Where's Queenfish? Looks like Queenfish had got screwed. Yep, we're stuck here. So, it'll get no repairs, and because I put it in there and I didn't take a look at it first, I'm going to need 2 or 3 days to get it, move it back and forth from the pier back out to readiness. Stupid, eh? Just stupid. But we got enough. At 14, 15 knots, I think we can get it down to Manila. Manila, we have, oh, these are the short range boats, the Shalimar and whatnot, so we can't exactly send them into near Japan, but we have two ready to go. We'll check the commanders, make sure that they're a 49. A 49. The guy should be in play school. Okay. What we're gonna do is we're gonna grab whatever here. Okay, and send them back out. Mapiro. A 50. Jeez, they're getting them out of high school. I'm just gonna grab one from down here and send both of them back up. We'll continue the repairs on Moray. All right, we sent them up, one to Shikoku Station and one to Nagasaki Station. Singapore, the usual raid and defense behavior, nothing much. Tarakan, I'm going to use the transports to move that one support squad out of here, back to Manila. Okay, nothing happening here, not much. Where Davao is now empty, all empty here. We're quiet at Legazpi, just moving past all the ships. At Manila, we have the same situation as before. We're going to lots of more amphibious. These guys, are they still unloading? No, these are fresh arrivals because they have escorts with them. The other guys have already taken off. These guys, yep, unloaded in 1 day. We'll take off. We'll do the same thing with the tankers. We will. These guys are docked. Just in case, we're going to dock. Really? We can dock these guys? Okay. Well, let's just transfer them over here. Oh, wait. Are there bigger ones that we can dock? Oh, hell. Let's just leave it here. Okay, and we're still room for others. Right, and we want to empty the smaller ones first. So I'll push some of these out of here. Transfer. Yeah, we don't want the big. We don't want these big ones. We want the ones with already low fuel, and then we'll empty them first and send them back. So, is that about right? How much fuel have we got here? I can't tell. I can't tell. Okay, let's try to drain those first. You have a bunch of destroyer escorts here. Refresh from the sea. Disband. Convoy, carrier escort. Refresh from the sea. Disband. So we're going to get all the escorts first, all the ones that really need it, sucked straight from the tanker. Okay, the next batch is we're ordering them to unload and head back for San Francisco. Can you believe that this is from day one and we arrived day 27. Took this long to either load or get them across the Pacific. 27 days. We just can't sustain this. That's how long it takes over, but we've managed to get what 2.5 million supply points and 1 million. Well, I don't know how much fuel we already had here, but probably about a quarter million of at least a quarter million in supply over here. As I was checking carriers over here, I realized that some of the escort carriers are still carrying top Wildcat 2s. Now, they're great for convoy duty and whatnot, but if we're going into harm's way, we're going to need something heavier. Now, what do we go? My choice, I really, is Bearcats or F4U-1s. The one deltas I'm leaving for the main for the fleet carriers and the ones, these have still got to be better than Wildcats. So I'm going to do these. The Bearcats I've been using to switch out the Marine squadrons on land, trying to free up the F4U-1s. Nope. So now that they're in port, got to go through all these and make sure that they, are these right? Yeah, make sure we upgrade to, yeah, get out of the Wildcats. Great for training, not much for an amphibious landing zone. The fast transports grabbed, stripped the naval, the support out of the engineering amphibious brigades. Okay, we're here now. We're going to put these guys in strategic mode. And we're going to march them over, let's see. We'll go San Fernando for now. Set all to march. The base force here, we're going to drop into movement mode and we're going to move down to Bataan to provide air cover for the base. These, there are still some naval squads here, which is okay. But rather than giving up 8, rather than giving up 200. Now, these are air transportable. So what I can do is I can take them from here. I can fly them over to Okinawa or somewhere in Okinawa and then fly them onto the Japanese islands, which is probably what I will do. Now that the construction is done on Apare, we're going to move the engineers back. Maybe we're going to stop them at Laog and Vigan just to repair the damage while we get out of here, while we evacuate. At Baton Island, those stupid mother nor got their asses kicked. Hopefully the night fighters here will be able to deter the enemy this time. We're close to 20,000, but we're killing the transport pilots doing it. So it took us a whole month to bring what a couple of ships could have done in a few days. Where are these? Okay, the commandos, the Skytrains. The commandos, well, we're getting quite a few replacements here, so I'm going to upgrade one of these guys to commandos. We'll give them a few spares as well. Okay, two left over. I'm sending a base force up here to challenge these guys to try to protect the base while we repair it. I'm just stubborn. I don't want to give the AI any free points for being an ass for these harassment attacks. They're just nuisances. But I've got the time. I've got the planes. Why not put them up here, protect it, try to evacuate one a bit at a time. And then pull back. Nothing, no big losses up here. Just harvesting pilots. Hahajima, the fast transports have arrived with the Royal Fleet Auxiliary Naval Support Regiment. We're unloading it. Well, it's going to be a little bit late for these guys, but at least it'll help the next ships coming through. The transports have unloaded the headquarters. We're heading back to Manila. We're changing the squadron combat air patrol again. Set all. I've been thinking, with this many, we haven't even had a single attack on us. I wonder if the presence of 300 fighters here is making some kind of an air defense, air superiority bubble. Regardless, these should be my main killing groups, with big 75s, competent aircraft and whatnot. These should be my killing groups. So I'm going to start looking for aircraft to replace them. Someone from Manila, maybe as a training squadron. We can send some what would you call those? Not pilot training, but trying to accumulate more experience, like these guys here. All they need to do is sit there and fly all day, every day, and gain experience. So I'm going to search for some replacement squadrons. I'm going to start pulling them out of Iwo Jima. There's really no need for long-range capable fighters to be sitting out here. Once we make the landing, we're going to need them on the island, the big squadrons, and I'm hoping I can leave two or three 24s or 30-some side squadron over here, just maintain control. That's what I'm hoping. All right, convoys continue to move back and forth. We have the carriers are dropping into Pagan. We're going to refuel, and I'm just going to disband these guys in here just to repair a little bit of the damage. Here's another one. Refuel and disband. Also checking the air groups while we're having some downtime. Well, how fortuitous. One of the damaged ships unloaded a Marine squadron here. We're here already. Why go all the way to Manila? Hell, let's just go. Let's see if we can do this. Let's transfer to Iwo Jima. 24. Let's get a... Well, we're here already. I was hoping to use the Corsairs elsewhere type and give them a different type of aircraft, but we're here already. So now we're overstocked. Let's see which squadron is on. The Mustangs are on duty. So I'm going to... These guys are recovered. Let's go back to the world. We'll rest here for now. Nothing eventful in Guam. Convoy still coming forward to Manila. But we're not going to have very many more of these. The cruisers arrived from Pearl Harbor. They got a little damage. We dropped them in here for repair. Ulithi, the evacuation convoy arrives. Let's load. Well, of course, it's going to be 17% that we can't get out of here. Oh, well. Take what you got. Let's send it for Legazpi. Lots more to pick up. Let's go drop it at the nearest port. Oh, Ravenas was heading towards Guam for pickup. Hell, for 17%, let's see if we can't pick up Ulithi. Make it a nice, clean sweep. At Lihu, two AOs have arrived. We started loading them. Form up. Transport. Okay, let's load. Let's top up. Not Saipan, Pagan. I sometimes like to click it twice just to make sure that they actually stay. Sometimes the convoy sometimes may just take off. That doesn't usually happen with transport. I've seen it happen more often with tanker or replenishment convoys, where you give them the load order and they just leave. Okay, this is the damaged, one of the crash test dummies, transport, APA. I'm going to set this one, we can only carry one half as many supplies. So why bother carrying supplies when we got other ships that can do it? Let's go back and let's go get some more troops. Nothing else? I think all the aircraft are out of here. Yeah. Los Angeles, we have three tankers arrived long way. Okay. You know, okay, I'm going to repair that tanker. Why? Because I can. The reason why I'm going to repair the tanker, it's only one point of damage. It's really nothing. It's really nothing. The fact is, we've just got so many damned tankers sitting at Manila. If we add another three, it's just adding to the backlog. We just can't get the stuff off the tankers. Okay, we're going to manage. We're going to continue loading these tenders, even while, yeah, they should be pretty much full now. There, they're full. So when they're finished, they can just go. Transports are in. Nothing, no real serious damage. The ones I worry more about are the engine damage, but no serious damage. So let's form up and grab some more. I preloaded the AE, the tenders. Oh, wait. We don't want to, I guess it's too big. Too big for the port. Okay, what are we going to do here? Let's get them off. Oh, I guess we're still too big for the port. Port size is... can someone tell me how big this one is? Without just looking at it? Yeah, I can't either. Stupid. So we go to this, we use the transfer the command, and we see that we're at fuel capacity... 325,000 tons, which is bigger than the port. Well, I'm just gonna do it, just because the ships will automatically, I guess you would call it the port master, harbor master, moves in ships one at a time to the port to load up. So I'm gonna let it go, even though we're too big for the port. I've got a couple of ships here with big damage. Oh, it says we've got damage here, serious damage, major damage, here. Engine wise. So we've got a couple of ships with engine damage, but they're not slowing down, so I'm going to continue. Let's load the troops. Same with the biggest guns first. Okay, so which ones? 1, 2, 3. Oops, let's not take the anti-aircraft artillery. If we don't need it, let's not take it. Really? Is that it? No fuel. Looks like we could use minimum. I mean, that's... Jeez! Really? We can load with that few ships? Okay. Off you go. I'm simply amazed at how much we can carry. So that's going to take a bunch and then probably another 250,000 in supplies over up to Manila. While these guys load, it'll give us the AEs a chance to repair. Okay. Sturgeon engages a destroyer. Miss. Croaker hit by a destroyer. Ray fires on a tanker. Miss. Sturgeon hit by the same destroyer. He's being stalked by those same one. Tambor fires a spread of torpedoes. Two hit the tanker. Poggi hits the same one? Maybe a different tanker. So maybe... Helens, night attack. Okay. Finally, those lazy bastards get in the air. Shoot one down. Night attack. They're engaged, and four are damaged. Another night attack, Baton Island. Two more Tsurugi damaged. Hahajima under night attack. Peggy's. Three Hellcats intercept. No loss. I'm beginning to think that maybe the double task forces for submarines, maybe that was a contributing factor to their destruction. Now that we're sending out singles, maybe they're just less submarines out. I have less submarines to send out. But now they're in single mode. I think they seem to survive a little bit more, a little bit longer. Singapore, under air attack. 18 aircraft, we shoot down 4. A good day. Singapore, under attack. 17 unescorted, a bad day. Lilies, bombing from 12,000. We should have been able to get him. Task force under attack, Hajima. 11 Bettys, 8 get shot down. Good score. Nago, under attack. 173 up, 3 shot down. Nago, intercept. Another 173, 9 shot down. 9 out of 15, that's not bad. Baten Island expands to Port 2, but we need the airfield up.